Three suspects in the deadly rock-throwing attacks remain in jail this morning, and we're learning more information about how the trio carried out the attacks and how investigators eventually caught up with them.
Let's get right to Jim Hooley, who has been covering the story since it happened more than a week ago. A lot of new data coming out about that cell phone and the towers and how they connected the dots, Jim.
Yeah, Ashley, good morning. We're over here at the county jail in Jefferson County. This is where the suspects are being held right now. We're getting this new information from the arrest affidavits released yesterday. They tell us that at least two of the three suspects now are talking to investigators, giving investigators a clear idea as to what they did the night of the fatal attack. And investigators are also giving, through the affidavits, a good idea as to how they caught up with the trio. Here's what's happening out here right now. Right after the attacks, the investigators requested what is called a tower dump from the phone companies. It gave them all the cell phone information in the area the night of the attacks. Police say 11 phones touched all four towers in the area that night. One in particular showed a path that traveled the very same time frame of the incidents that were reported. And that phone reportedly belonged to Joseph Koenig, one of the three teens now charged in the case.
Usually, you know who the suspect is and you're trying to find information. Here you have some information and you're trying to use that to identify the suspect.
According to the arrest affidavits, one of the teenagers admitted to driving back past Alexa Bartell's car after it was hit and she was killed and taking a photo of the car. They said they wanted to save it as a memento. All the suspects now being held here in the jail without bond. They're due back in court on May 3rd, next week. Live at the Jefferson County Jail this morning, I'm Jim Hooley, FOX 31.
Yeah, Jim, a lot of chilling details coming out in those arrest documents that we saw yesterday. Thanks for the update.